Welcome to ITU Telecom World 2018 here in Durban, South Africa, where I'm very pleased to be joined in the studio today by Mr. Mindaugas Žilinskas, who is Deputy Director General of the Communications Regulatory Authority of the Republic of Lithuania. Mr. Žilinskas, thank you very much indeed for being with us in the studio today.
Thank you for the invitation.
I'd like to start off by talking about smart digital development. What does smart digital development mean to you, and how is Lithuania working towards it?
Concerning Lithuanian development, I would like to say that we are progressing quite smoothly in this, without big hopes. Since implementation of fixed broadband, our government already decided to long-term plan how to digitalize all our possible services. And currently we are issuing electronic licenses, we are receiving applications for radio frequencies, for the numbers, and so on. A huge amount of services currently are on the internet. So it's not only which is related to our institution, but also e-banking, e-education, e-government. It's a lot of various services is on the internet now. And with growing internet, this area is widening and widening.
Let's talk about innovation. What's innovation, single innovation, let's innovative technology, let's talk about, or product strategy or policy, do you think will be most transformative?
I would say, speaking about innovation, I would say that the best hope, hope was made after we have introduced first digital dividend. So after introducing such dividend, actually market and customers felt much more better conditions for the receiving data. Of course, it went not so smoothly as we imagined at the beginning. You know that it was related with the switch off of analog television. It was not very smooth for all of customers, for all market players as well. We prepared quite well. We made simulcast for 5 years. We foreseen the compensation for set-top boxes for the people with low incomes and many other things. But nevertheless, for elderly people, it was a problem. And together with our operators, our institution were deeply involved in helping, in assisting all those people. Even we went to the certain places where customers asked, and we helped them how to accommodate these changes. Even people had to redirect antenna into proper size, so it was everything helped by our colleagues from our institution. So I would say that LTE, and especially LTE Advanced, made a big step forward in progressing of broadband development in Lithuania. And we are very keen to introduce 700 megahertz band, 3.5, 3.8 gigahertz band in the scope of this broadband frequencies. I would like to say that what you say, transferable, yeah? With growing capacity of networks, even our policies not require documents except your ID card. Everything can be found, can be checked through internet. Your license, your driver license, your insurance, everything, what your technical passport, everything can be found on internet in all country. What it means? It means that coverage of broadband has to be quite high, quite big. And currently we have coverage for UMTS 99.7% and for LTE up from 97 to 99% of whole country. So it enables us to provide more and more services. What interesting point I forget to mention? What changed the habits of people? I mean, its high capacity of networks enable us to provide even LTE, even TV on-demand service through LTE network. It means people now can watch television when they want and what they want, but not what broadcasters propose on certain time. It's a huge step forward, and we see the increase of number IPs customers, which are customers for IPTV through LTE or via internet or fiber networks, optic, very rapid increase.
We talked about the development of broadband a bit, but what about RRT launched a network speed regulation 2 years ago. I wanted to find out, how does it work, and do carriers then invest more in network quality than coverage?
Yeah, you see, it's quite interesting questions. Actually, we can say that it's regulation on speed. We just put some obligations for operators in licenses on speed. And it started in 2013, when we issued frequencies for 4G in 800 megahertz, and we put obligations in this frequency band, 800 megahertz, to guarantee 2 megabits, and from 2020, 4 megabits per each citizen. So it was made the first time such requirement. And last year, we during the auctions in 900 and 1,000 and 1,800 megahertz, we put the same obligation for all operators to guarantee for each citizenship 30 megabits per second speed, and for every second household 100 megabit per second speed in 85% of territory, with probability of 85% of time probability. So there is such speed regulation, and also what we are doing else, we are preparing, tuning our program to calculate, to check this speed theoretically, and we are doing quite well. I guess we will finish this method of calculation this year, and all results will be publicly available.
Right. Now, in terms of your attendance here at ITU Telecom World, you've come a fair distance to be here. I wanted to find out, what's the value of attending events such as this?
Yeah, you see, I would like to thank for organizer for such great opportunity to be here and to participate in such big event. It's give for us a lot of possibilities. At first, we have a possibility to meet operators who has already implemented new techniques, new equipment, which is still not being implemented, not tested in Lithuania. And we can share of their experience. It's marvelous, it's excellent a possibility. So also on this event, we can show various startups and so various, which is also it's necessary to know for regulators, because regulator he is theoretical, they are theoretical. We need to have more practice to know about how it's worked and when it worked, various conditions in practice cases. So, having this opportunity, I would like to thank ITU and the country which hosted this excellent event to give us such a possibility to present and to share experience, or even if somebody wants to to look at our experience. We are also ready to share our experience in developing broadband telecommunication.
Thank you very much for coming into the studio and sharing your insights with us, and we look forward to catching up with you again in the future.
Thank you for invitation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.